Good morning, Emerson. Virtual reality is the hottest trend in gaming right now, and we'll be testing out the HTC Vive to see what it's all about.
And an internship fair is coming to Emerson. We'll have what you need to know before the event.
All that and more today, Wednesday, March 22nd. I'm Claire Gomes.
And I'm Moses Small. We have a great show today. Ross Ketchke and Brian Danef are going to break down what's happening in March Madness.
And later, we're going to be looking at what games to get to make a great game night.
And now for this morning's top headlines. On Monday, FBI Director James Comey held a hearing and confirmed that the FBI will investigate ties between Donald Trump and Russia in regards to the 2016 election.
And that includes investigating the nature of any links between individuals associated with the Trump campaign and the Russian government, and whether there was any coordination between the campaign and Russia's efforts.
The White House denies connections, and Trump himself has said Russia is fake news. The FBI is set to have a rare criminal investigation involving the commander-in-chief. And also from the White House, Press Secretary Sean Spicer said yesterday that there could be changes to the Republican health care bill. House Republicans released a set of changes on Monday, which include lowering federal funding for Medicaid and stopping individual states from expanding it. Sean Spicer said there could be more changes to raise support to repeal Obamacare. Critics, however, say the bill could make it more difficult for low-income Americans to access health care. The House will vote on the bill this Thursday.
The Aaron Hernandez trial continues. The former New England Patriots player is on trial for the murder of two men. Hernandez fatally shot two men outside of a Boston club in 2012 and pleaded not guilty to the murders. His friend Alexander Bradley was supposedly with him during the drive-by shootings, and Hernandez has been accused of shooting Bradley as well as the two men. Bradley has taken the witness stand, arguing against Hernandez's defense, who claim that Bradley was the one who killed the men. Bradley and Hernandez are known to be friends, and Bradley was also a drug supplier to Hernandez in the past. It is unclear still who shot the gun and actually committed the murders. The trial is ongoing. A New Hampshire daycare teacher has been charged with assaulting infants at a daycare in Manchester. 2 weeks ago, Manchester police began investigating reports of child abuse at Alphabet's Learning Center. Daycare employee Chelsea Blaze was identified as the suspect in question. Blaze was charged with four counts of simple assault against three infants. Manchester police said that there were, quote, no major injuries, end quote, but further details of the infant's condition and the nature of the abuse is currently unavailable. Now for a local Emerson story. This Thursday, Emerson Career Services will be hosting an internship fair. Let's take a look.
The annual Emerson College Spring Career and Internship Fair will take place here at the Bobby Brown and Stephen Plofker Gym on March 23rd. Over 50 companies will bring their representatives to meet and greet students at Emerson about job opportunities and internships. Students are invited to stop by anytime between 12:30 and 3:30 p.m. Companies like Converse, Kellogg's, and Sinclair Broadcasting Group will be present. Every semester, Emerson Career Services sponsors the event to connect students with potential employers. I sat down with Blaine Butler, Associate Director of Employer Engagement and Marketing at Emerson College, and asked what students should expect for the fair.
So you'll walk in and go down to the gym. There'll be some tables there to check in. So bring your ID, your Emerson ID. You just tap your card. We'll have a map. You can kind of plan your visit that way. And what's kind of interesting, we started doing this a couple of years ago, is we have different colored balloons representing the type of internship or major that the employer is looking for.
He also described the process of earning academic credit for an internship.
Your academic department actually awards the credit. So they will review what's called the learning agreement. So the learning agreement is something that is a document that both the student and the employer sign off on as saying, you know, this is the description of the internship, this is what the learning outcomes I expect to get from it, and the employer says, yes, you know, that sounds like it's a reasonable expectation from this internship.
Emerson sophomore Michael Simon expressed his excitement about the event.
It just seems like there's going to be a lot of cool companies there that are actually looking to hire Emerson students, like, which is pretty different from then just searching for internships online and knowing that thousands of people all across the country and all over the world are going to be applying. It's kind of cool that companies are coming that just want to find Emerson people. So you got more of a shot, hopefully.
Butler advised students coming to the fair to do their research on companies, dress professionally, and make sure to bring multiple copies of their resume. To find out more about the companies that will be at the fair and other opportunities, visit careerbuzz.emerson.edu. For Good Morning Emerson in Boston, I'm Kimberly Wilborn.
All right. Thanks, Kim. What do you think, Moses? Are you going to be going to the internship fair?
I think I will be. Getting a job and having an internship and things like that can seem scary, especially for me as a freshman. So it's nice to know that there are things out there. I mean, I know you're on the other end. How are you thinking?
Yeah. I mean, I've had my internship for about a year and a half now, but I definitely used some Emerson Connects to get to it. So wish you luck at that internship fair, Moses.
Thank you.
I'm sure. I believe in you.
It's a good thing to have.
Okay.
I'm glad. I believe in me, too. That's good. And as of this week, it's officially spring. Here to tell us if we can actually expect springtime weather, we have GME meteorologist Corrales Placencia.
Yeah, it was officially the start of spring on Monday, and it has been feeling a bit milder, especially yesterday. But even with all the sunshine we're going to be having today, it's going to be feeling anything but warm. And especially with all these gusty winds, temperatures will start to even gradually drop as we get into the afternoon, you guys. And the reason for that is due to an Arctic cold front passing through the region early this morning, around 6 a.m. or so. And the temps will range from the mid-20s with the lower to mid-30s across southeastern Massachusetts, still in the teens in the higher elevations in Vermont and New Hampshire, with 16 in Berlin and in Burlington as well. We'll reach up to 32 degrees today before quickly dropping down to the mid to lower 20s actually around 5 p.m. Warmest of the spots will be by the Cape, but that just means the Arctic air has not reached them quite yet. It will affect everyone in the area tonight. Just look at the overnight lows. We're going to be having lows in the mid-teens throughout the map, single digits northwards towards Berlin. You can see 2 degrees. You can just imagine it's been a while since we've been having these temperatures this close to a zero with such a mild winter we've had this season. If we do factor in the winds as well associated with this passing cold front coming in from the northwest, it will be as high as 45 miles per hour at times. The wind chill values as low as -1 tonight as well as tomorrow. But Thursday's outlook has us with abundant sunshine still though, mid-30s throughout, 35 in Worcester. It's a little bit higher by the coast with 35 in Providence as well as New Haven. Still with those pretty strong wind gusts, we will eventually die down by the evening. We will be mostly clear at night, but we can see an increase in clouds as we go into the weekend. And on and off showers for the rest of your 5-day forecast at certain times. It will transition into snow briefly in the morning on Friday, but then mostly rain for the weekend. Sunday morning, we could see a brief wintry mix of snow and sleet before transitioning over to mostly rain with a chance of precipitation at 50%. It's like right when we feel like we won't be having snow, it always seems to pop up again. Last week's storm on Tuesday gave us a bit of an extended break for Good Morning Emerson, freezing our production of the show, no pun intended, but it's not uncommon for us here in New England to see all these fluctuations.
That's exactly it. We have the New England weather. I decided to go for a run this morning, and it was the most miserable thing ever, just so cold.
Terrible decision, like, Moses.
Yeah.
Carlos, please give us some good news. Tell us we're going to get some warm weather soon.
I wouldn't necessarily say warmer. It might be a little bit more mild into the 40s, almost 50s this weekend, but it's going to be accompanied by some rain, even a mix of some snow showers, kind of like a wintry mix this weekend. So we'll have to wait about another week or so before we can actually start seeing the mild temperatures along with the sunshine again. But I know I agree as well. I kind of struggled trying to decide what to wear, if I should wear a dress or some pants today, but I went with the pants. It's just a little bit too cold today, but we'll have to wait and see. We're going to start seeing the warm up once again.
That's exactly it. It's the cold challenges. I can't do the cold in the least, but I'll have to wait. We have to take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we'll be testing out the HTC Vive virtual reality headset.
Raj Ketchy and Brian Danif will be here for some March Madness talk, so don't go away. Welcome back to Good Morning Emerson. The newest rage in gaming world is virtual reality, and we were going to tell you all about it, but we thought it would be more fun to just show you. So we have Kate here to show us some HTC Vive. Hi, Kate.
Hey, guys. So the future is here, and while we don't have flying cars yet, and you can't ask Scotty to beam you up, we do have virtual reality, and the virtual possibilities there are endless.
I can see, I'm excited already.
So we have one of the latest technologies with us. We have the HTC Vive. It came out in April of 2016, and there are so many cool things you can do with it. There are practical possibilities. The BBC did a video on autism and took the Vive with them out to the streets and showed people that video. It was really cool. IKEA has an app, and you can make virtual meatballs in their virtual kitchen and pick out your whole kitchen. Very cool. You can also play some fun games with it. We played Pictionary. We wanted to test it out here live, but we got really excited and we did it beforehand. But we are gonna do it again here to show our viewers. So we're gonna put on our virtual helmet here.
What do you think, Kate? Who's gonna be first at bat?
Ooh, I think we're gonna give it to Moses.
Go for it, all right. We played this a little last week.
Yes.
A little scared because we established that I can't draw.
Yeah.
It's all right.
It's a different game.
Yeah. So I'm going to hand you these remotes.
Okay,
there you
you
go. And we're going to play some Pictionary.
All right. Okay. So I've seen a card beforehand and I'm going to draw. And Claire, it's your task somewhere over here for you to guess it.
Okay. All right. Sounds good.
All right. What do we got?
So.
Ooh, I like this marker.
Circle here.
Yes. So we ran into a problem last week where I can't draw, but now.
That's a pretty general problem.
Dog? A unicorn?
You got it. Unicorn. So you see the one? See this little silver guy over here?
That looks like an abominable unicorn.
It's an abominable unicorn, yeah.
It could be anything when you look at over here, but this is almost. Yeah, you see it's.
There,
the happy,
okay.
It's a happy one.
That's a really happy unicorn.
Really happy unicorn.
Moses had a lot of problems with the 3D world, so why don't you show them?
There we go. Let's show you.
So,
yeah.
If I walk around, you can see his mouth's over here, his eyes just kind of floating in space, but his body's in a solid spot.
All right, so we're going to give Claire a chance here, so we're going to pass it
off. All right.
Sure.
Take
these. All right, Claire, so look at that one.
Oh, what? Okay.
Beforehand. You gotta read us the category out loud.
Okay. I don't remember what the category is. I think it's a person, based on what I read.
Okay. So you're gonna pop that on your head.
My head's really big, so we might have to take time.
Might have to do some adjusting, don't worry.
Yep.
All right, ready?
There it is.
So Moses, I'm gonna hand you these so we can help Claire. There we go.
With my giant head. All right, there we go.
Aha. All right, Claire. So when you draw, make sure you draw out here so everyone can see it.
Let me see. And I know it's so cool. There's like these like little I feel like I'm like in amazing. I don't know. This is just too cool.
It's interesting being outside afterwards cuz now nothing else out
nothing
here
seems
real.
Nothing seems real out here now.
Anymore.
All right, Claire. Wow us with your artistic skills.
Oh, this is like very close to me. Okay.
Oh, dear.
Okay, and the category was a person.
Is that a
this gone,
a
maybe?
Devil?
Yeah.
Well, the devil? Oh, I see it. Okay,
I also have a little bit of trouble with this 3D plane right here. I could draw something in between his body and his head if I wanted to.
Okay, I'm gonna do one more.
All right, Kate, is that your turn?
Sure, why not?
Yeah, read the card.
Yeah.
Oh,
one second.
All right,
okay.
Oh,
I might have to adjust it back from my abnormal head size.
It'll be fine.
See, I know there are versions of these, you know, Google Glass or something with the phone, but this is just completely different.
This is gonna be really interesting. So it's from a movie.
Okay.
Oh gosh.
So we got a person. That's a good start.
Definitely.
That really narrows down the movie categories.
Person, is he?
Okay, so he's
on
a bodybuilder.
Scooter.
He's a weightlifter.
You're getting close with this scooter. That's a
something athletic.
There we go.
Mall cop.
No.
Oh, that could be.
Oh goodness.
That another person.
Is it E.T.?
Yes!
E.T.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh. I could
see
it.
I
not thinking you guys were gonna get that.
And the little E.T. That's a hard one.
It is.
Kudos for tackling that one.
Do one more. Alright, Moses. Last one.
You're at bat. You need the most practice.
Yeah.
So. Okay. I'm gonna elect to skip that card.
Alright, got it.
Back on. I have a deceptively small head, so this may not. It's maybe. Okay.
Just fit.
Okay.
There you
my right
go.
Hand. Okay. So I will cheat a little and say that this one is a fairy tale.
A fairy tale.
If you can, you can see what's going on. So, this
all right,
is here.
You're going to have to draw a little bit more in front of you there, Moses.
All right. I have this one here, and then it's all perspective. The size works out.
Okay. Ooh.
So they're going to be
Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Yes, that's exactly it.
Wow.
You go. You see, she has a hair and everything, and this.
She does have hair.
It was the little tiny people in the corners that gave it away.
I didn't know how close to make her. I mean,
Moses. Let's bring you back to the real world here.
All right.
Thank you so much for playing.
Oh my God, this was a lot of fun. We had a great time. Yeah. And I got a little competitive, so I'm glad that we could squash our beef. And I think we're all on the same level.
And the rivalry, it all worked out.
We will have a surprise for you guys later with the vibe.
Ooh, I'm excited.
I'm very excited for that. And Claire, I don't know about you, but my March Madness bracket is completely busted at this point.
R.I.P.
And now for an update on the exciting tournament, we have Ross and Brian.
Thanks, guys. Well, it's every basketball fan's favorite time of the year. The NCAA tournament is in full swing, and the top college hoops teams have been fighting their way to the Final Four.
68 teams started the tournament last week, but now we're down to the Sweet 16. Along the way, we've seen some incredible games and heartbreaking upsets.
Here's a quick recap of some of the most exciting matchups of the tournament so far.
First matchup we have is number 2 Duke, number 7 Carolina. They receive freshman Jason Tatum on the drive and dunk to start the game. He's real excited to be a young player in the tournament right now. Later in the game, South Carolina had this running all game long. Sophomore Chris Sylvia dunking on the fast break, and that formula would continue to work through them throughout the first and second half. Later in the game now, seeing Justin McGee is going to dunk on the break for the final points of the game. Number 7 South Carolina topping number 2 Duke, 88-81, and shattering my bracket while they're at it. You know, I never like to bet against Coach Gay, but South Carolina absolutely earned this win this week. Going now to number 11 Rhode Island versus number 3 Oregon, and in the first half, we had a bit of a block party as junior E.C. Matthews gets the huge block on the fast break. Later in the game, Rhode Island on the fast break, but junior Jordan Bell for Oregon getting another huge block. We saw some stellar offense to complement the defense there, as you see junior Stanford Robinson with the crazy handles and the shot for two. He's all smiles running back. Rhode Island was not able to stay in this one as they fell behind. That shot going just long to tie the game in the final seconds, and Oregon's going to win that one 75-72. They move on to the Sweet 16. Just some of the many awesome games that we saw in the first few rounds of the tournament, Brian.
Absolutely. So, Ross, now that we're down to the Sweet 16, who's your pick to go all the way this year and win the national title?
Well, it's going to be a real tough competition. I don't think anyone is super clear-cut. My pick for the Final Four is Butler versus Kansas and Wisconsin versus Arizona, with Butler and Arizona meeting in the final matchup, the national championship game, Butler coming out on top. I think that they have been on such an incredible shooting streak. They have been lights out the entire tournament and their few games coming into the tournament as well. And their defense is just stellar, whereas Arizona relies a little bit too much on their athleticism to put them over the top on offense. The moment they go cold, any team's going to be able to squeak by them. So I've got Butler winning the dance this year. Now let me ask you, Brian, because I know your bracket's not doing so hot either, no. But who do you have in our Final Four?
Well, my bracket isn't going great, but I still do have my original national champion pick, and that would be Kentucky. I really feel good about them. They've won 13 straight games dating back before the tournament. That's the longest streak out of any team currently. Again, John Calipari, I hate to bet against him. They've been playing some tremendous defense. And again, for my pick in the national championship, you say don't bet against Duke. Why would I bet against a team that beat Duke? I think South Carolina has a tremendous chance. If you beat a team like Duke, a juggernaut like them, an seemingly unbeatable force like them, I feel good about their chances making it to the national championship. We'll have to see how they'll fare against Kentucky. But Kentucky is my pick. And we'll both probably be wrong, but you know.
Well, that's all part of the fun of March Madness, and who knows, it's going to be some exciting couple of weeks of basketball ahead. While the NCAA tournament hasn't been the only madness going on this March, the World Baseball Classic is drawing to a close, and the championship matchup is set tonight between Team USA and the undefeated Team Puerto Rico in a winner-take-all game at Dodger Stadium.
Yeah, that's right, Ross. The WBC has showcased some of the best baseball players in the world, and with just two countries left standing, it all comes down to tonight.
Now, neither team could have reached this point without some exciting, drama-filled baseball, but Team Puerto Rico had a particularly interesting finish against the Netherlands in the semifinals Monday night.
With that in mind, let's take you back to Monday night in Los Angeles. Starting off here in the top of the first, Vladimir Ballantyne is going to hit a two-run home run into left field. But in the bottom half of the inning, Houston Astros shortstop Carlos Correa is going to say, not so fast. Whole new ball game once again, tie game. But later in the fifth inning, Puerto Rico would pull ahead 3-2. So in the top of the fifth, it'd be up to Sean Zoraga, who will lace an RBI double into left center field. That'll score one run. However, Baltimore Orioles second baseman Jonathan Scope is going to try to score from first, but he'll be gunned down at home. Yadier Molina with the tag. Later on in the game, bases loaded in the top of the 11th. Kurt Smith will ground into an inning-ending double play. So in the bottom half of the inning, Puerto Rico gets the same opportunity, and they won't mess up here. Rosario with a fly ball to center field. Tagging from third is Correa, and he will slide in safely. And Team Puerto Rico once again advances to that final championship game.
Wow, an incredibly exciting matchup right there, Brian. So tell me, what does Team USA have to do to top this seemingly unbeatable Team Puerto Rico?
Well, you know, as you said, they are unbeatable, but what's blown me away is their lack of pitching depth. And when you look at Team USA, they have an incredible bullpen. This is going to come down to bullpens. Marcus Stroman's getting the start for Team USA against Seth Lugo. Both major league starters are not stretched out to go 7-8 innings. Team USA has Andrew Miller to throw, Mark Melanson, Luke Gregerson. I think their bullpen is just better than them. If they get a lead and it's the fifth or sixth inning, I think it might be over kind of early. I think Team Puerto Rico has a great chance tonight, but they'll need to score early and often. If it's a close game, I have a lot of confidence in this Team USA team to keep a lead or regain the lead, and I think Team USA will win the World Baseball Classic.
All right, well, looking forward to that. It's going to be a really exciting game tonight out in California. That's all the time we have for sports.
Let's send it on back to Moses and Claire.
Thanks, guys. I'll be keeping up. When we come back, Kate is sticking around, and she has a surprise for us at the end of the show.
I know. I'm excited. I know you have something pretty weird in store.
It's a little scary, too, with the virtual reality set. Yeah.
Later, Juliana Bruno will be visiting a game cafe.
And Temi Adelaide will be here to show the best new board games to play on any occasion. Stay with us. Welcome back to Good Morning Emerson. Joining us right now is our lifestyle correspondent, Temi Adelaide. And Temi, what are you showing us this morning?
Well, this morning I have games for you guys, and games for everyone, really, that they could play indoors. As we all know, we're on our third day, of spring, and it's still kind of cold outside, so you guys need something to do indoors with your friends or maybe a significant other. Well, we have games for that. And all of these games were actually featured at the PAX convention that was earlier this month, where they cater to the culture and the community of gaming. So for our first game, we have Bananagrams. You guys, how familiar are you with Scrabble? I'm sorry.
Yeah,
I've just definitely... passingly, I've played it once or twice.
Yeah.
Okay.
I know it. I'm just not very good at it.
Yeah. Okay. Well, if you're not good at that, but you're good at spelling, you can still do pretty decently. With this game, all you have to do is just go ahead and pour out all of the tiles in the middle of the table, and then you pick about 8 tiles, and you go around either with your opponent or with your opponents, and you pick out tiles. As soon as everyone's finished spelling out their words, whoever has the most words wins. Then we also have Slamwich. With this game, all you have to do is you give everyone cards, and you guys slam, I guess you guys slap the cards, you flip them and slap them to create sandwiches. And if there's a robber, then they might take your sandwich. So you have to avoid that.
Yeah, I had this game as a little kid.
Did you
I'm
really?
Ready for this one. I did, yeah.
Did you enjoy it? Were you good at it?
I was not good at it, but I enjoyed it. Okay. There's a difference right there, you know?
Yeah, definitely. And then we have our board games. So we have Wits and Wagers. This one is probably one of my favorites. So with Wits and Wagers, all you have to do, it's a gambling game, but you're not losing any real money. So with this game, all you have to do is you pick a card, and after you read the card and you read the question out, everyone has to put down the answer or what they think the answer is. And then after that, they write down what it is. They gamble maybe 200 coins, 300 coins, and then whoever wins gets all of the coins. So there's that. And
that
then
sounds fun. More safe betting,
absolutely.
Especially being in college, not much to lose. So
absolutely. And if you want to gamble anything else, I don't know if we have cat cash or something like that, some type of money that you can use, maybe dining bucks or something, I don't know. And we also have Quelf. try to be careful with the title on its own. I had to deal with that one earlier. But with this game, there are 5 categories, and they're all different colors. So what you do is you pick the card, and it tells you what to do. So you can pick a card, and it tells you to sing Old MacDonald Had a Farm, but with your friend's name. So then you would sing Old MacDonald Had a Farm, E-I-E-I-O, and on this farm we had a Moses or a Clare, E-I-E-I-O. And then you sing that and you like keep playing. And I guess if you win, then, well, as you move forward in the game, what happens is whenever you win, whenever you get the answer right, you move up. But whenever you get the answer wrong or you don't do the dare, then you move back. It's a penalty. And then our last games are indie games. Now, these games were a little bit complicated for me. One of my favorites, though, between the two was divorce, because with this game, you could play it with a significant other or a partner, and pretty much you're fighting over, you're dividing your assets. So you're fighting over the children, over the dog, who has the most alimony, and things like that. So I don't know.
It's funny, on the box it says America's favorite pastime, so it's a little cheeky, I can already tell. I'm into it.
Like it might get a little real.
Yeah,
another.
That's pretty funny. I like the little play on the divorce rate. So.
Absolutely, absolutely. And then our last game is another indie game with someone who, the person who created the game was actually from the Boston area. So I think that's pretty interesting. And with this game, literally it has a total disregard for rules. All you're doing is literally following what the card tells you. So the card could say, pick up this card, and the card could say after you pick it up that your partner has lost the game already. Then your partner just loses. Has no rules whatsoever. You're just playing just to play.
Yeah, I like on the bottom here, it says 1 to 10 minutes. The range is pretty intense.
Yeah.
That's funny. I think I would be down for that just for the unpredictability of it.
It says 2 to 10 people, right?
Yeah. Let's just pull out 2 cards and see what happens. Read a couple examples. There you go. You play.
Take this one. Boom. Place face up in front of you and then take another turn. If there are 4 or more bombs face up, then everyone still in the game wins. Otherwise, if the combined total of bombs and bombs on the table is 5 or more, everyone loses.
Yeah. I'm already confused, but I'm also intrigued.
Exactly.
We'll have to play sometime.
Another time, definitely.
This week, Juliana Bruno headed over to Brookline to see how one cafe owner is taking game night into a whole new level. Let's check it out.
Night Moves Cafe in Brookline, a hangout spot complete with coffee, snacks, and an organic atmosphere, has just about every board game you can imagine. The cafe counter features many delicious options, including cappuccinos, milkshakes, and grilled cheese. The interior of Night Moves is rustic and cozy. Interesting trinkets are scattered among the massive shelves of games, making it a one-of-a-kind experience. We met with Devin Trevelin, the owner, to see what this game nook and cafe is all about.
Board game store, like a retail shop down the street, and there was, because of distribution and Amazon, board games were retail stocks in general having a lot of trouble, and so we created a service a service business where we would go out and we would teach games to kids. We started doing corporate events, birthday parties, and so then I broke away and I opened Night Moves as a sort of a mix between, there's not a lot of cafe culture in the U.S. I studied abroad for a while, and it's not that there's a much more homey feel to a lot of the cafes that are open late, and so I wanted to create something that I'm a night owl myself, so I want to be able to stay up late, and Boston doesn't really let you do that, so we're open till 2 a.m. to sort of create community, so people can have a place to go and hang out, play games with their friends. That's not necessarily a bar, that's the whole idea. In July, we opened a second location in Teal Square in Somerville. Its community is still growing. I mean, a lot of what we do is about slow growth. It's about sort of building community, building people. It's in a more, I would say, less diverse area and more family oriented. And so Somerville is really thickly settled. So there's a lot of people who live there who don't necessarily know about it. Because we do advertising, we do a lot of word of mouth and social media. But hopefully it'll grow into, its own community. And the types of games we have are anything from things you knew when you were growing up, from Parcheesi to Monopoly from 20 years ago, to brand new strategy games that take 6 hours to play or 2 hours of your time. And it's really, it's becoming a much more popular ideal. Settlers of Catan is kind of like what everybody hears and sort of like the gateway board game. And then as you can see behind me, there are thousands of games. When people come in, they're looking to have a different experience. I had a couple of girls come in and they're like, well, where are we? Because they thought they were, transported to a different world, which is kind of the idea, is that you're having an experience with your friends, you're meeting people, there's no pressure. Everyone has a common goal to play a game. You can talk to the people next to you. It's all about community building and meeting people, and people you wouldn't normally meet.
From Renaissance games like Splendor to classics like Risk and even hilarious modern card games like Joking Hazard, Night Moves has everything a classic gamer could want. For Good Morning Emerson, I'm Juliana Bruno. Back to you guys in the studio.
We have to take another short break. When we come back, we're talking about the new Beauty and the Beast with our pop culture correspondents.
And we'll be messing around with virtual reality one more time. We'll be right back.
Ready for it. Welcome back to Good Morning Emerson. Here to tell us about the remake of The Beauty and the Beast, we have our pop culture correspondents Jack Dodge, Mary Malloy, and Ruby Visnick. Morning, you guys.
Morning.
Hi. Beauty and the Beast premiered this past week, bringing in over $170 million in the U.S. and $350 million globally. Russia contributed only $6 million as it was given a 16-plus rating for its gay propaganda.
Okay, well, the gays loved it, so who cares? the whole problem was that LeFou, one of the characters, was basically openly gay for the first time in Disney's history. And I liked it. I thought it was a little bit stereotypical. He was very flamboyant, but so am I, so, who cares? Yeah, but it was cool to see, a start at least of gay representation in Disney films.
Yeah, and I know that a lot of people are pointing out that people are getting really upset about a gay supporting character in a movie about a relationship with a buffalo. So yeah. That's definitely something to think about.
It's a mix up of priorities, and I hear representation on LeFou wasn't the best, but I think it's a baby step in the right direction.
Yeah,
definitely. Yeah, so a lot of people were interested to see the new songs in the movie. Personally, I don't know how necessary they were. I definitely preferred the old, true classics. What did you guys think?
Yeah, no. Mary, you actually got a chance to see it. Can you tell us a little bit about the new songs?
The new songs, to be completely honest, weren't that memorable. I did musicals when I was younger, and I was in Beauty and the Beast, and I absolutely love the songs from the musical, and I wish they kind of included those instead of the new original songs, but they were still nice.
Yeah, I mean, it's still something new, something to keep the fans on their toes, I think that is fun. But moving on, Charlie XCX dropped her new mixtape, Number One Angel, debuting at number 8 on the iTunes charts, and it stayed there for 7 days, and then it also charted in 8 other countries. So Number One Angel didn't reach number 1, unfortunately, but I loved it. So it was actually a mixtape that is coming before her new album, which is supposed to drop in May. Which is interesting, because most artists release just one single and then the album, but she released 10 new songs, which is awesome. So that's a really new thing that, artists may be doing if they follow her lead.
Damn. Definitely. I think now, after the mixtaping doing so well, people are looking out for some videos to come. I know there's some anticipation with that. And people have seen her in the Fancy video with Iggy Azalea, so I think that's the next step for her. But yeah, any favorite songs?
I love 3 a.m. I think it is like a pop perfection hit. I literally have a playlist on Spotify called Pop Perfection, and it's mostly this album. But yeah, I think it's wonderful. Also, Roll With Me is a really good song if you like more like edgy, like bumpin' tunes. That's pretty sweet.
I heard Vroom Vroom as well. That was a really interesting track, very bouncy techno right off the bat.
That's an awesome song.
I'm glad she's branching out from her Iggy Azalea fame, because I definitely liked her more than I liked Iggy on Fancy, so I'm glad she's doing her own thing now.
She stole that song, so it's about time that she's releasing her own stuff. But yeah, well, I think pop, you know, she's doing her own thing in pop and, you know, making her own changes. So hopefully she will lead the way to a new awesome pop phase.
Definitely, this is not it for her. So, a beloved picture of actress Meryl Streep has been memed. Many of these are circulating and causing quite the comedic stir on social media. NME has named these Meryl memes the first great viral joke of 2017. Jack definitely agrees and has been making many of his own memes of this nature. That's Moses so and Claire, do you have a favorite Meryl meme?
You want me? All right. I have been absolutely trolling Twitter for these memes. I love them. I love that they're bringing back old songs from like way back in like middle school. My personal favorite is Apple Bottom Jeans, Boots with the Fur. It just cracks me up. And Moses was saying earlier this morning, it works with like any song.
That's
basically
the thing. I mean, I've seen a couple. I've seen a lot of ones about trap music, and my favorite is Gucci Down to the Socks, Like I'm Biggie Papa, Baby. No, yeah, that is ridiculous.
Yeah. You guys have any favorites?
I mean, first of all, I do not make these memes. I just want to say I made one for the show, and it was to the window, to the wall. So that was funny. But yeah, I mean, I really like that one because I made it. But there's a lot that I really like all over Twitter.
My favorite was, I don't know if you watched Zoe 101 growing up.
Oh, yeah.
But it starts a song and it's like, are you ready? And it goes, ooh.
I loved all the ones about like old stuff from like the 2000s when we were in middle school. And I know there was ones about like Panic at the Disco, like Broom's Grimes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Just all these ones just crack me up. Ruby, do you have any favorites?
I can't think of any. I know earlier we were talking about the Bohemian Rhapsody ones. I feel like that works for the whole song. And just in general, so many songs have that like echo, so it's great. I'm like, a hands up.
Yeah, and she's like in her mouth, but then a smaller inside her mouth.
I've seen some edits too that make her mouth gigantic. That's a whole different thing.
Poor Meryl, she's like always in the news. But I think it's hilarious that it's a 2015 picture of her that's just now surfacing. It's like, the internet is crazy.
Memes, am I right?
Memes.
Thank you guys so much for coming in and talking. Memes, Charlie XCX, Beauty and the Beast, that's like top three right there.
Everything we need right now.
Yeah, totally.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Early in the show, we played some Pictionary with our VR headset, but now we're going to be walking a tightrope. Kate Bell rejoins us now. Kate, what do you have in store for us?
So we said that we had a surprise for you earlier, and I am very excited. I've had this one in my back pocket for a little bit. Cannot wait. So we're gonna have Moses go first. So Moses, if you could join me on right here, if you sit right here, then we're gonna hand you our headset.
I've been hearing many of the things about the surprise.
I know, it's very exciting. So I'll put that on, and then we're gonna put the headphones in so that you are completely immersed in this experience here. So there's one.
One here.
All right.
Because I can hear all the cars and trucks
here. There you go, yeah.
Give that a try.
All righty. Okay. These.
Right.
Let's make sure they're on.
This one of them?
Yeah.
Okay.
There we go, all right. So what you're gonna do, you put that in that hand.
All right.
So you're going to turn, you're gonna look to your right. So you don't have to move, but just look to your right. All right. So you see the plank button.
I do.
So you're gonna reach out and you're gonna pull the trigger on the plank.
Just tap that one.
There
you go.
Stand right there.
All right.
And
I'm on an elevator.
There we go. Let's make sure you can't hear anything. Let's immerse you in this. There we
go. Now I really can't hear.
Okay. I'm very excited for this. I can't wait.
I can definitely tell he's going up. I have a bad feeling about this, Kate.
It's a bit of a heart-stopping experience. All right, so Moses, you're going to take some steps forward here.
Okay.
There you go. There. Got this. There you go.
I love this stance right now.
I don't have a fear of heights, but I don't like this already.
All right.
No.
So Moses, you're gonna. What do you see?
I see everything below me, a city, a couple birds over here. I'm a little too high up for my liking, but
All right, so what you're gonna do is you are going to take one giant step off that plank.
Oh, okay. Yep. Which, any direction?
So yeah, just take a big step forward right now.
Okay, I will.
There you go, big step.
Oh my. Dude, you can see the scream. It's a completely weird, oh my goodness.
All right, so we are going to bring you back, Moses, into the real world. And we're gonna let Claire test this out.
Okay.
Okay, Moses, you all right?
Yeah, how are you doing there, Moses?
I'm good. See, I don't have any fear of heights. We talked about this earlier. I think I just got one. Because there's nothing like
just given
having
Moses
your whole
one.
Body just flying down.
I'm like, kind of excited.
All right, Claire, ready? So I'm going to hold on to that, and you are going to put that on your head.
This is like I picture virtual reality as like the new genre of horror. I feel like there's so much you could do with
pushing people off buildings.
Yeah.
All right, so we're gonna put these in your ears. So
ooh,
you can hear.
I don't like
that.
That
is the right ones. There's one, and here's the other one. So if you can put that in your ears, so that way Claire can't hear a thing.
Right.
I don't like this.
All right, Claire.
Okay.
Immersed.
I think so.
We'll give you that, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna walk back into the elevator. So you're gonna take a step back there, and you are going to go. You're gonna hit the plank.
Oh, there you go.
All right.
Oh, this elevator music is horrid.
Oh no.
This might
you
be
get
the
elevator
worst
music
part.
In real life and in virtual reality.
Yeah, this might be the worst part.
That's the first thing that hits you. The music is just. Okay. I'm in there.
So I didn't do it with the sound when I did it. And so I didn't get this elevator music.
Oh, goodness.
Oh, there's a helicopter. Well. All right, ready? So you're going to take a big step forward. There you go.
This is so weird. Wow.
All righty.
This is so strange.
Look at the view.
Okay. Yeah, I also want to point out that there's like this giant city, but then there's a large mountain. This just doesn't make a lot of sense. And
right, but you're also
better.
Standing on a plank about nine stories above.
This is so weird. Oh, goodness. Well, there's that fear of heights.
Oh, keep going. Goodness. You got it. You got it. Keep going.
I'm also stepping on the wire a little bit. I can feel that. This is just the strangest experience, but it's also, like, kind of cool.
All right. Are you ready?
I'm into it. Oh, my gosh.
Take a giant step forward. Ready?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Hold my hand.
All right. Ready? Go!
Oh, my God. That was the weirdest thing.
Oh,
that's so
right.
Oh my God. Everyone needs to experience
Claire
this.
Claire really hit the ground here.
Oh my God, all my senses are messed up right now.
See, exactly, you come up and then it just brings you right down.
Okay, it's different. My mind is blown and that's all the time we have this morning. So thanks so much for waking up with us.
Have a great Wednesday and we'll see you back here.
I need to recover. I need to.
I'll be in a corner somewhere.
Correspondent for Good Morning Emerson. If you liked what you saw and you want to watch another clip from this episode, click the link on the left. And if you want to watch another video from this season of GME, click the link on the right. Thanks for watching.